Allah Azza wa Jal told us that successful are the believers. What are their characteristics? Allah mentioned few characteristics about the successful believers. May Allah make us all among them. What is the first characteristic? The ones who have khushu' in their salat. The one who have khushu' in their salat is a successful believer. How many of us can say, I have khushu' in my salat? The question I want to ask myself and I ask you. First of all, is khushu' in salat achievable? And the answer is absolutely yes. How could Allah praise people that do not exist? Right? Allah is saying successful are the believers. Who are they, Ya Allah? The one who have khushu' in their salat. That means khushu' in the salat exists. Now the question is, and please listen carefully, my brothers and sisters, these are short khatiras, are literally a reminder. How much effort did you put to achieve khushu' in your salat? Many of us are still praying the way their father taught them, or their imam taught them. Nothing has changed. No improvement whatsoever. Allahu Akbar, Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika, Subhana Rabbil Azim. You ask, what does Subhana mean? He does not know. What does Ghasiqin Ida Waqab mean? He doesn't know. Nothing. I'm just praying because I have to pray. How are we going to achieve khushu' if we do not put the effort? Just like anything else in life. You want to become successful, you have to put the effort. Similarly, you want to have khushu', you have to put the effort. And this is literally why I started this series about explaining the dua is in the salat, so I can understand what I'm saying. So now, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we finished 3 dua before I recite the Fatiha. And you do not say them all at the same time. You choose one and you alternate. One salat you say this, Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. The next salat you say, Allahu Akbar wa kabira. The third salat you say, Allahumma ba'id bayni wa bayna khatayai. The one we took last week. Now today, subhanallah, one more and then I will move to the rest of the du'as of the salat. One more du'a before the Fatiha. There are 3 more authentic, but I'm going to take only this one and I will move forward, inshallah. In one narration, it says, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا قام إلى الصلاة قال, and then it says this du'a. And in another narration, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا استفتح الصلاة كبر ثم قال. In one narration, it says, when Rasulullah ﷺ stood up for the salat, he said, and in another narration, it says, that was dua al-istiftah. After he said takbir, then he said this dua. That's why some people, and which is approved by the scholars, some people say this dua before the salat. And the dua is, وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له بذلك أمرت وأنا من المسلمين. Or another narration, وأنا أول المسلمين. Listen how amazing is this dua. وجهت وجهي, I am facing, not only here, وجهي does not only indicate my face, I am facing Allah Azza wa Jal with this ibadah, with this salat that I'm about to pray. I am sincerely doing it for the sake of Allah only. My intention with this salat is to please Allah only and not to please anybody else. وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ To who? لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فَطَرَ, one of the names of Allah is Al-Fatir. And one of the names of Allah is Al-Khaliq. What's the difference between Fatir and Khaliq? Fatir is from nothing, to create from nothing, to originate, the originator. Fatir is the originator. Khaliq, when you repeat the creation again, you say Khalaqa, you don't say Fatara again. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used for the samawat and ard, like the Shaykh recited in Surah Al-An'am, Fatir al-samawati wal-ard and Khalaq al-samawati wal-ard. He used both. But Fatir is the first time it was created, is used Fatir. When you repeat it again, you use Khalaqa. I am facing Allah Azza wa Jalla, the one who created this magnificent Milky, these magnificent Milky Ways, this amazing creation of the heavens and the earth. I am now standing and facing him, fully facing him. وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ حَنِيفًا. حنيفا. The word أحنف, a person is called أحنف. Anybody knows what أحنف means? Does not mean that he is following the Hanafi madhab. أحنف means a person whose feet is like this. الأحنف بن قيس, one of the great تابعين, he used to have his feet like this. They called him أحنف. أحنف is a person that his feet are opposite direction. So what does that have to do with حنيف? سبحان الله. حنيف means inclined, مائل. حنيفا, I am inclined to توحيد and I am inclined way away from shirk. That's why Ibrahim حنيف, right? I am inclined towards توحيد and I am inclined way away from shirk. حنيفا. And all three words are the same. حنيفا, مسلك, مسلما, وما أنا من المشركين. All three means the same thing. حنيفا. And then I'm saying, I am a Muslim. I submitted to Allah with everything that I have. وما أنا من المشركين. I am not a mushrik. I am confirming that I'm not a mushrik. Even though حنيف by itself is sufficient, but this is more emphasis. How much tawheed do I have? Now imagine someone starting his salat by saying, Ya Allah, I am facing towards you with no shirk whatsoever. I am a muwahid, Ya Allah. Is that person gonna pray in a manner that to show others, to have riyah? Impossible. I am declaring myself and I'm Muslim, Hanif, not a mushrik. And imagine with all that, I am showing my imam, I'm showing my mother, I'm beautifying my salat. Impossible. When you start such a salat with a dua from the bottom of your heart, وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي, الله أكبر, إِنَّ صَلَاتِي, my salat, يا الله, وَنُسُكِي, نُسُك, two meanings. One meaning means all kinds of ibadah is a nusuk, just like we say manasik al-hajj. All kinds of ibadah under nusuk. So why did he say salat and nusuk? Salat is part of the ibadah. This is when you put the specific before the general. Malaikatu wa ruh is general before specific. When you say here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna salati, or it's an ayah, Allah said, Inna salati, my salat and my nusuk, all my ibadat. Another meaning of nusuk is sacrifice. Ibn Abbas said, nusuk means sacrifice. Ya Allah, my salat, my sacrifice. Why specifically sacrifice? Because as we all know, the mushrikeen in Quraysh, they used to sacrifice for their idols. Now I'm singling myself out of this shirk. Inna salati wa nusuki, and my sacrifice, and all my life, every moment of my life until the day I die, وَمَمَاتِي, إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Have you ever seen any more tawheed than this? And imagine saying all this and I have shirk in my heart. How can I start my salat with such a dua and I do not have khushu'? Can you imagine? Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati, till the last moment of my life, I'm gonna be a worshiper, ya Allah. Wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Another confirmation. La sharika lah. He has no partners. Wa bithalika umirt. And this is what I have been commanded to do. Wa ana من المسلمين. And I am proud and honored to declare I am a Muslim. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله أكبر. What kind of salat you will have when you start like this? When you understand what you're saying. Now some people say, but Sheikh, I read it in وأنا أول المسلمين. أول, some ulama said you can't say أول because it's an ayah in the Quran, right? In Surah Al-An'am also. And others said, no, no, awwal is specifically for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because every prophet, every messenger, he is awwal al-muslimin to his people. He's the first Muslim to his people. And you're not the first Muslim to your people. So some said you can say it because it's an ayah. You're reading it anyway. And some said, no, no, there is another narration, authentic. Wa ana mina, I am among the Muslimin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us live on tawheed. and die on tawheed. May Allah Azza wa Jal, I ask you the best of your names. Ya Allah, I beg you, make their last words, La ilaha illallah. Sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.